This is a 20 by 30 high tunnel here. This is donated and built by FarmTech out of Dyersville, Iowa. And what we have out here is a mix of vegetables that you'd commonly see in high tunnels. Tomatoes would be the most profitable, and so they're the most common, the ones we see. We also see peppers very common, both bell peppers or chili peppers or hot peppers. Slicing cucumbers or pickling type cucumbers, so the very high-end, high-quality seedless types are very common in there. And then we see raspberries and blackberries. A lot of raspberry varieties are not hardy in Iowa, so we have a limited selection, but when we put them in one of these tunnel systems, we get a little bit more hardiness out of them. If you'll see on the board here, some of the advantages that are listed out is that we get earlier in the season in the springtime, but we also get it into late fall. That basically allows us to have a very short window of time where nothing or fruits and vegetables in the state of Iowa are not in season. The lifespan of these high tunnels can be 20 to 30 years. It has to be drip irrigated. Essentially, the building is a desert environment. Drip irrigation is fairly inexpensive to use. If you have a well already on the farm, typically that well will provide enough water output to supply that high tunnel. The value of these structures is that we get more produce in an area. We get cleaner fruit. We have less disease in the tunnel, which means we spray pesticides less often. High tunnels are a lot of work. There is a sharp learning curve, but there is a lot greater profit on a per acre basis with one of these systems, and the quality is just that much better. Anybody that's growing fruits and vegetables in the state now is going to having at least one of these systems, and typically after they put one in, they're putting more than one in. They're that popular, and people are really seeing the benefit of having them on their farm and in their production system.